Good evening, students. So today we are going to learn about the Michaelis-Menten equation and its derivation. It's very simple and it's very important for the examination aspect. The first of all, we should know that the Michaelis and Menten, okay, both of them, they elucidated this that the Michaelis-Menten equation. So based on the assumption that the steady state analysis. The first step of the Michaelis-Menten derivation is enzyme. So this is enzyme and substrate will form enzyme-substrate complex. Okay, this forward reaction, the K1 is the rate constant, and this enzyme-substrate complex will form enzyme and substrate again. Okay, by the reversible reaction, that is the rate constant for this reaction is K-1. So next one is the ES, that is enzyme substrate complex, further forms E plus P, that is enzyme plus product, for the forward reaction the K2, and the backward reaction is K-2. So early in the reaction, the concentration of the product, that is P, is negligible, so the P gives S can be ignored. So that means the rate of formation of substrate concentration from the product is very negligible, because in the early, that is in the initial state, the formation of the product is very, very, very less. So that is why the product formation is less, and due to that, the substrate formation from the product is very less. So we have to consider this one. And the next one is if you're combining all the reactions, that is equation 1 and 2, combinedly, will give the equation number 3, that is E plus S gives ES with the rate constant K1, and the backward reaction is the rate constant is K-1, and ES gives E plus P, the rate constant is K2. So till now, we learned about only 3 reactions. And the next step is the initial velocity, that is initial velocity V0 is determined by the breakdown of ES to form the product. So that means the initial velocity V0 is very important, and this V0 is calculated so based on the formation of ES. So this formation of ES, if you are looking into this, this ES formation is limited by this K2. So this K2 is very important, because so this is for the formation of ES. So the initial velocity is determined by the breakdown of ES. So breakdown of ES, so this ES will form E plus P, with the rate constant K2. So that is why K2 multiplied by ES. So V0 is equal to K2 multiplied by ES. So this is the fourth equation. The next step is ES, that is the concentration of ES, is not easily measured experimentally. So the alternative expression is necessary. That means the ES concentration is very difficult to measure, because it is an intermediate. So this the intermediate, or it is not a stable one. Okay, this is very difficult to measure. So that is why we need some alternative for measuring the concentration of ES. So we have another strategy, that is the calculation of E, that is free enzyme concentration. So this free enzyme is, this is free enzyme concentration. So that is E is equal to ET minus ES. That means the total ET, we have to derive, the total enzyme concentration as ET. So this ET minus ES, that means total enzyme concentration minus ES, will give the free enzyme, that is the free enzyme concentration. So this is very simple, and this is equation number 5. And the substrate is here, the substrate is greater than ET. So that means the total enzyme concentration is there, means if you look into the concentration, the total number of substrates and total number of enzymes, the maximum is the substrate, because due to the size, the substrate is very small when compared to the enzyme, and Okay, looking into the steady state kinetics, okay, substrate is greater than ET concentration. That means the total enzyme is less than the substrate concentration. So that is the amount of substrate bound by the enzyme at any given time is negligible compared with the total substrate concentration. So that is the amount of substrate is bound by the enzyme at any given time is negligible compared with the total substrate concentration. So with these conditions, okay, in mind, okay, the following steps can be used to derive the Michaelis-Menten equation for the value V0. So that means we have to derive the value V0. So for the calculation of V0, the nearly five steps, okay, we are going to follow. The first step is the rate of ES formation is equal to the K1 multiplied by ET minus ES. So it multiplied by substrate concentration. Actually, this ET minus ES is E. So the instead of E, we use ET minus ES. So K1 multiplied by ET minus ES into S. That means the ES formation, the rate of ES formation. So please come to the equation number 3, the rate of formation of ES. So this rate of formation of ES, the factors are involved. Okay, ES, E, that is enzyme concentration and substrate concentration. So the rate constant is K1. So we arrive the value K1 multiplied by, so this is K1 multiplied by E, that is enzyme and substrate concentration. In the place of enzyme, we used the value, okay, that is ET minus ES. That's all. Second point is, so this point is over, and this one is rate of enzyme substrate breakdown. So please come to the equation, that is number 3. So breakdown of ES. The breakdown of ES, so one is the formation of E enzyme and product, okay, that is K2, and the formation of enzyme and, okay, substrate, okay, that is the formation is centrally different and the breakdown is centrally different, okay, this is breakdown. Breakdown means K minus 1 multiplied by ES. So K minus 1 means the formation of, sorry, the breakdown of ES and involved with K minus 1, and so another parameter is ES related with K2 also. The K2 means the formation of enzyme and product formation. And this is the equation number 6 and 7. I hope you understand. Okay, the step 1, we are going to arrive the value. Okay, that is for the rate of enzyme substrate formation. Okay, this is the formula. And the next one is rate of enzyme substrate breakdown. So K minus 1 multiplied by ES plus K2 into ES. Okay, this is the formula, that is equation number 7. Next one is step 2. Step 2 is in a steady state assumption. Okay, that means in a steady state assumption, that is ES is constant. Okay, that means in a steady state, what is the meaning of steady state? At a particular point, both the formation of ES and the breakdown of ES is equal. So that is what is called as a steady state kinetics. In a steady state assumption, the enzyme substrate complex is constant. That means its formation and its breakdown is equal. So we are going to arrive at the value, that is, so take the formula, okay, now that is the equation number 6, okay, here, and equation number 7 here. So both are equal, so that is why, so the formation is equal to the breakdown. So this value is, the formula is, that is the equation is 8. So till now we learned about the step 1 and step 2, and the rate of enzyme substrate formation is equal to rate of enzyme substrate breakdown. Okay, so with this we are going to the next step, okay, that is the continuation of, okay, this one. We are going to arrive at the further values also. Okay. The 8th equation I wrote here. So K1 multiplied by ET minus es multiplied by s and k1 multiplied by es plus k2 into es. So this is the same thing. Okay, in the previous page I wrote, okay, the equation 8, the same equation I wrote here. And so this is the formation of es and this is the breakdown of es. I hope you understand. And the next one is step 3, that is the next step. Okay, for the derivation is we are going to simplify further. Okay, for the derivation, and so we can multiply, okay, this one, that is k1 into et into es, the et into s minus k1 into es into s. That means k1 into et into s. Okay, this one, and further k1, that is k1 into es and into s. So this is the further expansion of, okay, this equation, that is k1 into et into s minus, because the minus value is here, minus k1 into es into s. So this is the expansion of that is equation 8, which gives k minus 1 multiplied by es plus k2 into s. So this is same. So this and this are same, equal. And so this is the step we already completed. Okay, this one, so that is the equation number 9. It's very simple, just expand, okay, the left side of the equation into the little expansion. Okay, that means k1 into et into s minus k1 into es into s. So we are going to further simplify, okay, this one by adding the term. Okay, that means adding the term k1 into es into s. So this one we are going to add on both sides of the equation. The both sides of equation means, okay, we are going to add, okay, this k1 into es into s. So that means here in this formula, so we are going to add both sides of the equation. That means k1 into et into s, so minus k1 into es into s, that is already available. Okay, I'm going to add, okay, this one, this is a new parameter we are going to add on both sides. So this is already available one. Okay, I gave it in the blue color brackets, and this is the one we are going to add both. So now what will happen? Okay, this one, so can be cancelled, okay, by this one, because this is minus k1 and this is plus k1. So this minus k1 into es into s can be cancelled with plus k1 es into s. Okay, to simplify, okay, this one is cancelled with this one. So further simplify, okay, this one, and k1 into et into s is equal to, and so this is the remaining one. So this is the one I gave. And so if you are taking the commonly, because es here is also, es is there, es is there, and es is there, and if you are taking es as a common one, and you can see here, this is es is taken, and remaining is k minus 1, that is here, and k2 and k1. So taking the common parameter, okay, es, the remaining k minus 1 plus k2 plus k1 multiplied by s. So k1 into s is there. So don't forget, okay, this s, if you are leaving the s, okay, you will not get the formula. Okay, that means the remaining k minus 1 plus k2 plus k1 into substrate concentration. So this is the further simplification. Yeah, so next one is the 12th one. So take this one and bring all the parameters in one side. Okay, that means if you are keeping, okay, es, okay, this one, and k1 into et ds is there, and this has to come to the bottom of the equation. So this is further simplification. The equation number is 12 now. And further simplification, which will form es is equal to, and that is, we have to divide by k1. Okay, this side we have to divide by k1. I'll tell once again. Okay, this one, the further simplification here, what we are going to do, we are going to divide, so this k1 and this k1 also. So this is as a simple that is a further simplification of the equation. So for the first one, okay, the top one, the k1 and k1 can be cancelled, and this k1 and this k1 will be cancelled. You can see here in the black. So this k1 and this k1 can be cancelled, and this k1 and this k1 is cancelled. I think you hope, I hope you understand. So very simple. For here in this step, further simplification, we are going to divide, okay, so divide k1 on both, okay, top and bottom of the equation. It's very simple. So here what we are going to do, so don't be confused. So this one divided by k1, and this is divided by k1, and this is divided by k1. Okay, so what we have here, so this is k1 e to into s, the same thing here, and k my k1 into s plus, and k minus 1 plus k2 divided by k1. Okay, this is also there. So because we are going to divide, very simple. So I took, okay, this one separately and this one separately. Okay, right. So next one is, that is a further simplification. So after cancellation of this k1 and this k1, the remaining is et into s. Et into s. Okay. So this et into, so et into s is there. And actually here this is not es. That is s. And the denominator is this substrate concentration is there. And the remaining k minus 1 plus k2 divided by k1. Okay, this is the equation number 14. So based on the dividing of k1 on the both sides of the equation, so we got the equation number 14. Okay, this is the number 14, and this is further simplified into this reaction number, sorry, equation number 15, because the k minus 1 plus k2 divided by k1 is denoted as km. So here, so k minus 1 plus k2 divided by k1 is, we have to spell it as km, Michaelis-Menten constant. So that is why in the place of this, so I put the value km. So the same et into s, so divided by km plus s, the remaining, okay, this one is s. So es is equal to et into s divided by km plus substrate concentration. So this is equation number 15. Okay, I hope you understand. Okay, next one is the equation number 16, that is the step 4. So this is step 4. All the three steps are over. Now the fourth step is there. V0 is equal to k2 into es. The previously, okay, we derived a value of V0. So that is the initial velocity is equal to the that is degradation of ES. Okay, so that means how much amount of ES is degraded into, or otherwise further produced into. Okay, that is E plus P. So the rate constant is K2. So it's very simple. V0 is equal to K2 into ES. So this is equation 16. So now I am going to so put the value of ES, okay, here. So this ES is here. I'm going to, okay, put all these contents, okay, in this position. Okay, that is P0 is equal to, so K2 into ES. So this is full of ES. Okay, then I'm going to multiply. Okay, the maximum velocity occurs when the enzyme is saturated. That means the maximum velocity is means that is velocity maximum, V max. Okay, that is all the enzymes are saturated. So that means all the enzymes are occupied with okay, the substrate, and all the enzymes are attached with the substrate. Okay, the Vmax is equal to K2 into total concentration of the enzymes. So now I'm going to add, so K2 into ET, okay, here, that means so here in this place I'm going to add, so this Vmax, so Vmax into S Km, so this is Km and this is S. So this is called as Michaelis-Menten equation. Okay, this is very simple, and I'm repeating the step number 4. Okay, that is velocity, initial velocity is defined as that is degradation of ES, and rate constant is K2, so K2 into ES. So we can arrive the value V0 is equal to K2 into ES, because we already derived the value ES here. So this is ES. So this ES, we are going to put it here. Okay, and the maximum velocity, that is the velocity maximum, is equal to K2 into ET. So the K2 into ET here, it is there. So we are going to put the value Vmax and in the place of this, and remaining is S is there, and we can put the S and divided by Km plus S. So V0 is equal to Vmax multiplied by substrate concentration divided by, so Km plus substrate concentration. So this is called as Michaelis-Menten equation. So this is very important, this derivation, and this may be asked in the examination, okay, in the section C. I hope you understand all the steps, okay, in this derivation. I wish you all the best. Thank you.